Hello and welcome. My name is Daniel Rimmelswan, and in this video, I will answer the question, how do I add a field in an extension for Microsoft Dynamics 365 Business Central? We will add a very simple field to an existing table object. To accomplish our goal, we'll go through four easy steps. First, we will create a new table extension object. These objects are used to add functionality to a base set of objects. In this case, we are going to extend the item table in standard Dynamics 365. In step two, we are going to add a field to the new table extension. In step three, we will then create a page extension object so that we can add the new field to the item card page. And finally, we will add the field to the page extension object. Along the way, I will show you how to use snippets that make adding new objects and fields a piece of cake. The completed extension will look like it's been part of Dynamics 365 all along. Let's get started. We're in Visual Studio Code, and I have prepared a new workspace called Awesome Item. For the first step, we are going to create a new table extension object. We start by creating a new file, and let's call it Awesome Item. Let's use the table extension snippet to create the object definition. All we need now is a number for the table extension. 50102, we'll give it a name, Awesome Item Extension, and we tell it which table to extend. For step two, we are going to add a field. We want a checkbox, which means that it is a Boolean type field. Let's use the field Boolean snippet to create the field. We need to specify a field number, a name, and the data type comes from the snippet. To finish the field definition, we need to specify a caption. Finally, let's get rid of the variable section because we will not be writing any code. We are done with the table extension. We want to show the new field on the item card. So for the third step, let's create a page extension. We start by creating a file. Let's use the page extension snippet to create the object definition. All we need to do now is set the object number, a name, and the target object that we want to extend, in this case, the item card. The final step is to add the field to the page extension. The requirement was to add the new field to the general fast tab, and we wanted to show right after the blocked field. In the layout section of the page extension, we add the add after anchor, and we specify the blocked field. Note that IntelliSense suggested the name as we are typing. To add the field, we can use the field page snippet. When you type the field name, IntelliSense knows to suggest the item field, and note that IntelliSense is aware of the new field that we've just added. Also note that the snippet inserts the field name as the name and also as the source. All we need to do next is define the application area to make the field show up and all. Finally, remove the actions and the variables because we won't be needing those. Let's see what this looks like in Dynamics 365. When we open the item card, you can see that the Awesome Item field is displayed right after the blocked field. In summary, we created a table extension object to extend the item table. We then added the Awesome Item field to the table extension. We created a page extension object to extend the item card, and we placed the new field on the item card right after the blocked field. Topics covered are extending tables, extending pages, and using snippets in Visual Studio Code. For more information, please follow the link on your screen. Thank you for watching this video, and have a nice day.